finally made it. Oh my gosh, what a crazy 24 hours it has been in Las Vegas, don't you think?
Some rain, a little bit.
Now, I didn't get that storm yesterday.
We're so close. I didn't get it either. I had no the thunder yesterday afternoon and just kind of passed by my area. And I thought nothing of it until I jumped on social media and saw the news. I started seeing I first saw some national coverage. I'm like, oh my gosh, we're getting hit right now.
It was crazy.
You don't have to be Mr. Olympia to be considered a champion. It all comes down to how you go about your day going in the gym day in, day out. But it's the adversity you have to go through in order to make yourself, you know, the best you can possibly be. And sometimes those things are negative things, such as an injury. So I think, you know, it does change a lot, but you have to, you know, have yourself mentally prepared. I always feared that through my whole career. It was always a thought how I trained, and I always kind of mapped out what kind of workouts I would do so I avoided injury. But obviously it's not always those things that cause the injury, it's just sometimes wear and tear, or just, you know, something happens, just a freak accident. And in my case, when I tore a bicep, it was, you know, something I've done over and over and over. I mean, it was in a photo shoot, so for me it was you know, it was hard on my mind a lot. I didn't expect it. Of course, I was the Olympia champion at the time, and for me to be able to, you know, lose that Olympia because of an injury, it affected me a lot. And I thought, oh my goodness, my career is over. I'm never going to recover from this. And you know, I worked with people around me to give me a positive influence. I think that's the most important thing. And I always said that bodybuilding really, as much as it looks physical, a lot of it's the mental preparation, the mental capacity that you have to handle in order to be able to be a champion.
Ich weiß genau, wo ich gestürzt bin an dem Tag. Und mein Quadrizepssehne ist abgerissen. Der erste Gedanke ist scheiße. Ich kann nie mehr trainieren. Scheiße meine Sponsoren. Scheiße mein Sport, das ich über alles liebe. Kann ich jemals wieder trainieren? Kann ich jemals wieder der alte Athlet werden, der ich vorher war? Gott sei Dank kann ich sagen im Nachhinein, es ging alles wieder gut. Es wäre der Super-GAU gewesen, wenn es zu meiner aktiven Zeit gewesen wäre. Das wäre das Karriereende mit relativ frühen Jahren gewesen. Deswegen kann ich mich in Dennis genau einfühlen und weiß, was ihm durch den Kopf geht. Glaubt mir, also ich kann es genau fühlen. Und ich weiß, und ich will ihm einfach nur Mut zu reden, dass das alles wird. Wenn er an sich glaubt und stark ist und er einen starken Rückhalt hat. Und der starke Rückhalt muss seine Familie sein, müssen Freunde sein und Sponsoren sein. Und dann kannst du alles wieder schaffen, das ist kein Problem. Wenn es natürlich der Genesungsprozess weiter so vorwärts geht, wie es momentan wohl aussieht. Und die Prognosen sind ja wohl relativ gut für ihn.
After the diagnosis, I was mentally shocked and mentally really down, because I was thinking about all the negative things. You know, I'm not going to be able to train as I trained before. I'm not going to be able to compete at that level. Anything else, what comes in your mind, you know, all these things you already done in your life, you know, you remember that, and you feel like you're going to be forced to retire. But you know, that was in my head probably the first 4 weeks.
Heard about Dennis's injury. I think online I saw something on Instagram or something saying, okay, I'm going in for surgery or something. And then it was kind of, actually, you know what, it was actually when I was in Pittsburgh and he was supposed to show up to guest pose, and then someone said, oh, he had a shoulder injury or something. It was talk about it, but I thought, okay, you know, I know the prior year or 2 years before, I know he had had some back spasms or something which was kind of affecting him. So no one talked about it that serious, but then as it started to progress, you know, more talk about it, a couple people that were kind of mutual friends with told me, oh, he's having surgery for, you know, something simple like a neck issue or something. I didn't realize how extensive it actually was. But, you know, then of course, you know, I saw the pictures online of him.
Ja, ich muss ganz ehrlich zugeben, ich bin jetzt nicht jeden Tag im Internet und lese jeden Ramsch, ja, aber Dennis war jetzt nicht zu überlesen. Ich bin auch bei meinen Seminaren öfters angesprochen worden. Dann habe ich dann auch mal ein bisschen erkundigt, auch über Team Andro natürlich, was gelaufen ist. Jetzt ist immer die Frage, was ist Wahrheit und was ist immer so ein bisschen Klamauk, was im Internet steht. Das war von Querschnittslähmung über keine Ahnung was. Deswegen, ich habe mit Dennis nicht geschrieben. Ich habe ihm auch nicht geschrieben, mit Absicht nicht. Weil ich denke, der Athlet hat genug mit sich zu tun. Mein Gott, es war vielleicht, nachdem er wirklich die Verletzung hatte, 3-4 Wochen später. Und dann habe ich auch das gelesen, dass er operiert worden ist. Und habe auch die Bilder gesehen, wie schmal der Dennis Wolf in momentaner Form ist, wenn man das so nennen darf. Aber ich meine Gott, das ist ein Mensch, der schwer operiert worden ist und eine schwere Verletzung hinter sich hat. Ich glaube, der hat momentan ganz andere Gedanken, wie einen 60er Arm auf seinem T-Shirt zu haben. Und jeder Mensch, der da Dummes schreibt, der sieht so dünn aus. Na gut, dem kannst du natürlich nicht mehr helfen. Ne?
Wie geht's dir?
Naja, bin am Leben.
Du bist am Leben. Ich bin, wundert mich ein bisschen. Wir haben nämlich, beziehungsweise auf dem Facebook-Account gab es eine Anfrage.
Oh je, was kommst du jetzt?
Ja, die aus Schweden wollte jemand wissen, ob wir bestätigen können, dass du verstorben bist.
Okay, so schlimm ist es nicht, aber ich muss ihn leider enttäuschen.
Also ist nicht alles in Ordnung?
Ich bin verletzt, aber ganz genau weiß ich nicht, was es ist. Ich muss mich noch untersuchen lassen und muss demnächst MRT machen und dann weiß ich Bescheid.
Wie gesagt, die Sache ist wirklich, die spekulieren von wie gesagt, Schweden, diese Anfrage mit verstorben, dann... Du wärst querschnittsgelähmt, das sind die wildesten Sachen im Umlauf aktuell.
Ja, ist verrückt. Ja, das Problem ist, dass ich Gastauftritt abgesagt habe und der Veranstalter hat das veröffentlicht, dass ich verletzt sei und man sollte für mich beten. Ja. Aber so schlimm, denke ich mal, ist das nicht oder wird es nicht sein. Aber ich werde mich ja bald untersuchen lassen, konkret und dann werden wir sehen.
Ja, dann halt mich mal auf jeden Fall auf dem Laufenden und ich hoffe, dass es deutlich weniger ist, ja, wie möglich oder wie du vielleicht erwartest oder vermutest.
Ja, in ein paar Tagen habe ich mein MRT und dann werde ich Bescheid geben, was jetzt eigentlich Sache ist mit mir.
Das hört sich doch nach Plan an.
Ja, wenigstens etwas.
Sonst, Katja und den Hunden geht's gut?
Alle gehen gesund, Gott sei Dank.
Ja, dann würde ich sagen, bis zum nächsten Mal. Oder wir hören uns demnächst, wenn du deine Diagnose hast.
Machen wir so.
Tschüss, tschüss.
Danke für den Anruf.
Immer gerne. Bis dann.
Die Sau, das ist kein Auto.
Vito, so hat das nicht raus.
Yeah, Hector's is a little bit slow because he's already 9 years old. So for English Bulldog, it's you know, already a lot, I guess. And he's been with us since 2007. so almost the whole pro career. Been traveling with us everywhere until 2012, because he's been with us back and forward to Germany, back from Germany to US, you know, so he's a travel dog. Yeah, but then in the last few years he had like 4 surgeries, a lot was fixed, you know, his eyes. Right now he's almost blind, and of course he gets tired pretty much after a few minutes already, you know. Hey, what's that? None of the dogs is just a dog for us. It's just, they're lucky kids for us. And I think, you know, every human being understands, you know, how it feels to have some, you know, animals or pets at home. And, you know, for so many years. Like I said, he was with us everywhere. All my guest appearances in Europe, took him with me. You know, so only in the United States he's not flying with me around, because that's just weird and too much stress for him.
So, here's it for today. Oh, he's so fatty.
He's been third at the Olympia last year. From Germany, now living in Las Vegas, let's hear it for the big man, Dennis Ward.
The greatest moment in my life was winning the Arnold Classic in Ohio in 2014. I was working so hard for that, and I did already 2 times the show before and always finished second. And I always feel like I always can win that show before I can win the Olympia. And 2014, fortunately it happened, and that was just unbelievable. Because I never thought before I'll gonna win something big like this.
Sean Roach!
Arnold Schwarzenegger is one of the, you know, most recognizable people on this earth, and as everybody, I was also a big fan, because, you know, at the time the movies were, you know, always full with guys like with muscles and thigh, you know, that was always great to see that. But like I said, Arnold Schwarzenegger and asking me a couple questions, you know, I did a small speech, you know, of course. There was not that exactly what I wanted to say, but you know, at that moment, you don't think that much, you know. You're just overwhelmed with happiness, and then of course, you know, as my wife came on stage, that was just, you know, the just the moment, perfect for this evening, you know, winning the show. And my wife came on stage, just, you know, crying like crazy, and just that was the greatest moment in my bodybuilding career. I never thought that I'll be at that level or my life gonna change that much as I was a young boy or a kid back in Kyrgyzstan or Russia or Soviet Union. Anyways, correct. But I wanna say that I always wanted to be a professional athlete, and at that time I was playing basketball, so my dream was to be an NBA professional. So, but I quite not hit the pot, but I'm close. I'm still in sports and yeah, doing well. In the beginning, as I started bodybuilding, there was so much going on TV, in the media about bodybuilding and what is all around. We all know they always put negative things in it. And I think at the time, it was, I think, the great Andreas Muntzer died at the time, and so it was all over the media, and yeah, of course, they were scared, you know, to hear what I'm, you know, what I love to do. But as the years pass on, as I start winning shows, of course, they you know, supported me a lot.
You know, it's funny because, you know, he's had to take a lot of time down. I know mentally that's frustrating, because I always said, you know, in all the literature in the last, you know, few years with the Olympia, you know, I was always a big Dennis Wolf fan. I felt he had the overpowering physique where he stood and he looked like Mr. Olympia. You know, the problem is obviously there's a lot of guys like Phil Heath or Ty Green who have a lot of detail and a lot of striations, so Dennis's condition always mattered the most. Ooh. Because listen, he has the best structure of the guys, you know, wide shoulders, small waist, you know, big quads, he had it all. But I think what he always had an issue with, which was my issue, is nailing the condition so he was full and tight at the same time. Now he's hit it a couple of times where, you know, he got a good look, probably not as good as he should have, but he has no problem putting on the size. So In my eyes now, looking at Dennis, I don't see any issue of him getting back, as long as the doctors say, okay, you can train this way. I know he's gonna go at it as soon as he possibly gets that red light in order to train. And there's no question, within 2-3 months, he'll be right back to the size. Now he just has to mentally say, okay, sidestep the whole injury process and how it happened. Don't be afraid to do certain exercises that are gonna help him develop that physique back to win the Mr. Olympia, because he has to have no fear when he goes in the gym. He has to train like he used to train and be able to get that right mindset to be as big and hard as possible. And I think he can do it, because he liked to train more than anyone I've seen. I mean, I watch his routine and he lives it by the clock. And not a lot of bodybuilders can do that. And I have to respect it. And I always said, because I could have been a greater Mr. Olympia, I could have been a greater bodybuilder. I chose to take the path of traveling nonstop, and it affects a lot how you train and being in your home gym. But his routine is exactly the way it needs to be, and it was exactly the way that I structured my routine until I actually won the Mr. Olympia, where it was clockwork. He trained every day at the same time, you know, trained the same ways. He didn't have to change a lot of things. If he squatted 5 plates, he did it every week. He didn't try to do anything fancy, because he realizes, okay, this is what it takes to build muscle. So you have to have respect for someone that has that game plan. And he's not one of these guys that someone's telling him, hey, you need to do this. He has a great support system with his wife. He's not out, you know, in Vegas partying and doing all the other things that a lot of the guys end up doing. So I think, you know, for him, he has the structure to make this a lot easier transition to bounce back to exactly what he was. I have no question he can be standing right up there with the best of the best in no time.
We're not gonna. What do you have planned today?
City Athletic, because, you know, they allowed it to film.
birthday?
October 30th, 78.
Oh, thank you.
Right,
Dennis,
oh, Dr. McGee. Good morning.
How are you feeling?
All right.
Yeah.
Still problems, but.
Still problems.
Yeah, it's like no end, no end of that.
Okay, we'll check it out.
Yeah.
Talk about a game plan.
Figure out, I guess. Thank you.
All right, just stand up against here, just like this. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Just tilt your chin up a little bit. There you go. Are you prepping?
Yeah, we'll see.
All right, for this next one, you're going to have to kind of hold your mic down.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Small step forward, yeah. Yeah, good. All right,
cool. Appreciate it.
Yeah,
thank you.
No problem. Dr. Schneier just wanted to see your x-rays.
Okay.
But he's glad you're doing well.
Okay.
Yeah. But that's it. You guys are done.
That's it.
Yeah, unless you want to talk to Dr.
Yeah,
Schneier.
Yeah?
Yeah? Okay, cool.
Thank you.
All right. Glad you came in. Perry can email you the x-rays.
Oh, this is good. Yeah. I want to see them too.
So, but the x-rays, I just want to get a follow-up x-ray. So, an x-ray will just show us that the implant is in good position.
Okay.
And there's no screw bone failure.
Mm-hmm.
So everything looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Eventually, you're going to get a biologic response or a bony fusion, like healing a fracture.
Mm.
But that's a biologic process. So that takes as much time as 6 months, probably maybe to a year. But
okay.
You're healthy, so it'll be about 6 months. But you're free to do what you want to do. I just want to make sure that there was no screw bone failure or any collapse.
Right,
like
the like
bone kind of subsides, it'll soften and push through.
Mm.
But not everything looks good, and you can keep this as a baseline. I mean, obviously you travel, so if you ever want to follow up somewhere else, you'll have your own records. If you gone back, you look like you've gone back.
A little bit, but I still can gain weight because my workout is still not the same. You know.
All right. Before I used to be able to bring it. Now I brought Perry. Give me a football push. So before I could break
it.
Right, now go up. Wait, go up. Go up 45. Higher. Now hold it. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's much stronger.
It's much better.
Yeah.
But like you said,
this this was my favorite.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Wait. Don't keep the elbow
control. All right.
You ready?
Good.
So, I mean.
It's getting better. But
yeah.
It's
the belly's
still,
Wait. Now hold it here. Ready? Resist?
Yeah.
No, it's... Wow.
It's
the belly, the definition is back too.
Yeah.
Before it was atrophy.
Yeah, it was, you know, a lot smaller.
Yeah,
this
it was
part.
Atrophy. Yeah.
Yeah, but it's still, you know, because I still can get my feeling back, you know, because if I just push, you know, the bench press or something, I feel like the right side is still working a lot more than the left side.
Well, and that's what's going to happen is like, and you may not know it, because the battery will charge.
Like you said, yes. Like you said, the first exercise is good.
Yeah.
And then afterwards, I'm so weak. It's just like before the surgery again.
What I was afraid of is it just drop out to zero, right? So you'd be, you know, pushing weights and then the arm would give out. But you haven't found that.
No. It's like the first exercise is really good.
Yeah.
Like I feel really strong, and then it starts like getting weaker and weaker, and then at the end I just can't control the left side. You know.
Let me see the incision.
Yeah, there was a stitch right here.
Yeah, you popped a stitch, you split a stitch.
We tried to pull it out, but didn't go, so we pulled it as much out, you know, as possible out and cut it off. So, but it's still, you know, something there, but I don't know.
All right.
Because it was so, I don't know, so thick and deep, couldn't even pull it out.
Do you want me to pick at it?
If you want. One question.
Yeah.
I forgot to ask you the last time. What happened to me at the surgery? I was covered with blood. My head was covered with blood.
They put needles into the scalp. So because we're working on the spinal cord, you're watching the electrical conduction from the arms and the legs through the spinal cord to the brain.
Okay.
So those needles are electrodes, and they sort of measure the amplitude of the waveform.
Okay.
So we could see that the nerve was depressed, mm-hmm. so the amplitude of the nerve was depressed. So you get a sort of a wave, and then if the spinal cord went into sort of shock, you'd see that too. But obviously it was just more precaution than mm-hmm. anything else. But mm-hmm. I mean, we were over the spinal cord, so we wanted to make sure that the spinal cord was functioning.
I'm gonna pick up this.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a stitch there, Doc? Mm-hmm. That's what I'm trying to figure out. I think he's, oh, that was it. Yeah, he spit the stitch, but I was gonna bet it was gonna be pus more than anything, but it's not. Yeah, that's
good,
it.
Though. That's it?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that was it. But, yeah, the incision will heal, will thin out. You can still use some sunscreen on it mm-hmm. just to sort of prevent the collagen breakdown. Mm-hmm. But I'll shave because you look shaved. If you can shave, I can shave.
Yeah, that was the thing. I was on vacation. I couldn't shave. So, like, beard like that. Everyone was watching me, like.
Perry will email you the x-rays. You're free to roam. You're free to do what you want to do.
I'm working out for the third week right now.
Yeah.
But it's, you know, it's every week I make some progress, but the progress is not so
right,
huge.
But the
you know?
Idea that you made progress in the first couple of weeks when you really haven't hit the regeneration phase means that you're probably going to rebound now in the next 4 to 6 weeks more than you think.
Okay. Well, okay.
Because the protein cycle has been against you.
So.
So
yeah,
you
yeah.
just had a release
that's
from
what I
nerve.
Thought.
So now the protein cycle.
And like you said, we don't know how long it was compressed, and you
it
know
it was good and compressed though.
The pieces were broken off.
Yeah.
You took them out or just put the implant?
No, no. And then I went down over the nerve root and found the free fragment of disc.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
There was a fragment of disc that was free and migrated.
Wow.
So that yeah, that's why like I saw the nerve mm-hmm. bounce back or rebound.
Oh, uh-huh, okay.
So it was almost
so you saw right away that it's
well,
right
it
away like free.
Dimensional, and then okay. it became like the neural tube became
yeah.
three dimensional.
Okay.
So
cool.
In theory, in about 6 more weeks, you get a follow up X ray. In about 6 months, you can get a CAT scan because that will really show you best bony fusion.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're doing well, it's all sort of suggestive.
Okay.
So at this point, you're not going to fail. You know. Biology works for you. There's not going to be any screw bone failure. So just use a little common sense. But
yeah.
You know, you had sure. surgery for the purpose of getting back to your life. So
yeah.
whatever you
yeah.
want to do, you're free to do.
Cool.
All right?
All right.
And don't make me track you down again.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Okay.
All right. Alpha Beta Zen.
Get out.
I think the most important thing is you have to have the certain mindset to avoid that things. You have to surround yourself with a positive influence. And I think my family, my friends, I mean, that's who really gave me the most support. And in the end, they talk about bodybuilding as an individual sport, but it's something that requires a whole team. It's not just an individual thing. So sometimes you have to start there, but then when you go in, you have to give yourself a vision. I mean, I consider bodybuilding an artist form. So you have to say, okay, how can I perfect my physique from this, even with the obstacle of having to train around an injury?
All right, my doctor was able to remove the broken pieces from, you know, the neck area, so they're not pushing anymore on the nerve roots. Yeah, and C5 and C6 are connected now with some screws and a plate. So I'm kind of bionic man right now. Yes, so 3 weeks after the surgery, I was able to walk in the gym for the first time ever again. And yeah, trying to lift some weights. The training went well, but of course, after a few sets, I went back to the, you know, powerless, no controlled exercises, you know. It's kind of, I was kind of thinking, you know, this is like first time ever in my life in a gym, so that was a weird feeling.
You get a lot of massages?
No, not yet.
What happened?
Yeah, some pieces broken off.
Mm-hmm.
C5 and C6, so like, I don't know, in between. So this, like, 2-3 pieces, really small. Mm-hmm. They were pushing on the nerve roots.
Do they make you, when you bring people up to target? Are they cool?
What I do now, I ask the manager, or my partner, he's asking him, and then it's cool, you know? They just sign up and sit.
Oh, man. There's a low rat, lat hammer strength there. One that comes down lower.
Oh, that's cool, I do that.
This one here is reverse. We got those three there. And then I'm trying to think other back stuff.
It's 6 weeks after surgery, so we're getting some back today. Really light, no hardcore training, because I'm still not 100% there. Yeah, the recovery is going on and I feel good. So, step by step, every week, moving forward.
And I honestly didn't go to the doctor until after the contest was over, because it happened 3 weeks before. What was I going to do? I wasn't going to pull out as the champion and use the excuse. I mean, that was my mindset. I wanted to be the best bodybuilder. So for me, I was just, you know, staying in the gym, training around it. Obviously couldn't train as heavy, but all those things cross your mind. And I think, you know, at the time I was highly endorsed as an athlete, so I'm thinking, oh my goodness, if I lose this, then my whole career is going to be shot sideways. But sooner or later you come to realize that there's a lot more than just, you know, being the greatest bodybuilder. And I've adapted to more lifestyle since now I've stepped off the stage, of course. But I think for me it was just, you know, being more positive about going in the gym, and I think overcoming the fear and the feeling I had when I actually tore the bicep. And you know, that I can still remember the day what like it was yesterday. And I said, wow, I never felt that before. So I knew something happened that hadn't happened before, but I just didn't realize how serious it was. And then I wasn't sure about a surgery. I've never had a kind of a surgery. I kind of always said in 20 years, I never was injured, so I never expected to have an injury. And it wasn't gonna knock me out. I still was gonna get in there and compete, but it faltered my ability to actually win the competition. I fell with second place, which was, you know, still respectable, but it just wasn't the same.
Looking great.
It's, you know, it's okay. We're moving forward a little bit after surgery. Like, it's been 5 weeks.
You just had your surgery recently.
Yeah, 5 weeks. So four or five weeks. Yeah. Like, see the sky.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
So. But everything's smooth. Recovery is good.
Yeah, recovery is going well, but slow. So we'll see. The last few years, I changed my nutrition completely. You know, I don't buy anything from normal grocery stores. Everything what I eat is organic. So we're here at the Protein House. Larissa Rice is the owner, she's a superstar in our business. So we're gonna have a post-workout meal here. So let's see. I feel it, you know, because all these chemicals, you know, in all these products, which I used to eat all the time, you know, over the years, really had some impact on the health. Right now, I feel really good. Since I did it, you know, everything what I changed, you know, in the beginning was a little bit weird, but right now it just, you know, keeps me healthy. And I like it, you know, just anything what I eat, chicken, meat, whatever, it's all organic. If I train in LVC, Rainbow, so I always stop at the Teriyaki Boy. If I train somewhere else, I prefer to go to Protein House and, you know, get some calorie bumps, you know, after the workouts, because right now it's a very important time for me to get some mass on, or back on. All right, how you doing?
Hey!
Thank you
for coming!
Ah, it was a pleasure.
How are you?
Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Very good.
How are you, beautiful?
Good. How are you?
You
You guys want to try something with
them? Yeah, it's been a while, so yeah.
I don't know what you look like. So off season, pre-contest, or
you see me.
You look good, man.
You look like I lost 50 pounds. Yeah. Yeah,
good.
I had a surgery, so yeah. So now I'm trying to, you know, gain weight.
But you're going to compete?
I don't know yet.
I don't know.
It's like 10 weeks out right now. It's hard.
It is.
I mean, your time is so fast, you know, it flies.
It's a business. That's
Yeah, but you know, I think it's too early.
Let's do a
too early.
Here.
Yeah.
Let's do a team like hardcore gym and MMA.
I'm open to that.
Yeah.
Let's talk.
Okay, so you guys be free to
choose sleeves, full.
Choose whatever you want. The smoothie thing. So smoothies, or if there is anything you want to change, they can change for whatever you want. I go with this one. Yeah, okay. Chocolate BB Crush. Anyone of vanilla chocolate? Yeah. Anna, can you do for me chocolate BB Crush with half vanilla, half chocolate? Okay. Good. Yeah, so you can have as a bowl or as a smoothie. So it's like a meal as well. You eat that, you feel full. I feel full when I eat that. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds good as a smoothie.
Yeah.
There's also whey in it, right?
Yeah, everything has whey.
Cool.
Everything has whey.
And as you said, a lot of calories.
It is.
Good.
This is a lot of calories.
That's what I need.
Yes, it's like you eating beans, you know?
Oh.
Beans and rice, a lot of calories. But it's good because it's
healthy. Good too?
Yeah. Superfood. Okay. It's a superfood.
Oh, I'll take that.
Yeah. Which one? We have all those three.
Mm.
This one has more shitting going on here.
Wow.
This is big.
Wow. Is that normal banana? Yeah, let's do this.
This one with strawberry, yeah?
Strawberry.
Okay.
I am a professional bodybuilder for 10 years. So I'm not going to the gym for likes on social media or, you know, that people can look at me and, you know, just say, wow, or this and that. I train to deliver on stage. You know, I train for the biggest show in our business. This is the Mr. Olympia, the Super Bowl in our business. So in Super Bowl in bodybuilding. And this has always been my dream to compete there and of course to win the show.
Heute in den sozialen Medien ist es natürlich einfach, auf jemanden einzuhauen und reinzuschlagen. Aber ich glaube, ein Profi wie der Dennis Wolf oder andere Profis wissen doch mit Kritik umzugehen, die unter der Gürtellinie sind und dann eher so als lächerlich abgetan werden. Ja. Die wahre Kritik kommt, glaube ich, von Sponsoren, von Sportlern, die natürlich auch die wirtschaftlichen Interessen vertreten. Und das ist ein wichtiges Ding. Steht der Sponsor hinter mir? Gibt er mir Rückenhalt? Ja? Sag mal, so wie bei mir die Firma Allstars, wo ich meinen Quadrizepsabriss hatte, gab es kein Mäkel und kein Jammern von der Firma Allstars, sondern nur Unterstützung. Und das bringt dich wieder voran. Das bringt dir Kraft und Energie. Wenn da irgend so ein Idiot auf Facebook schreibt, du bist eine Fotze und du hast 30 Kilo abgenommen, ja. Mein Gott, der Dennis hat vielleicht jetzt mehr abgenommen, wie andere jemals aufbauen werden. Ja? Insofern ist das ja lächerlich. Und ich glaube, Dennis Wolf ist Profi genug, um zu wissen, auf was er jetzt hören soll und was einfach nur albern ist. Ob er es jetzt wieder, wie gesagt, mental hinbekommt. Ich glaube, der Dennis ist ein starker Athlet, ja? Der auch natürlich über seine Erfolge gewachsen ist. Insofern glaube ich nicht, dass er das jetzt sich so zu Herzen nimmt, sondern ist mental stark genug, um das wieder hinzubekommen.
You know what, you're going to get criticism, and I think someone like me wasn't bred into being Mr. Olympia right away. I mean, I was second to last at my first one, and then I moved up, and you know, I was second, and everyone said I wouldn't win, and then of course I win, and then I lose it, and I come back and win it, and then of course lose it again. But I think the most important thing is you have to have the certain mindset to avoid that things. You have to surround yourself with a positive influence. And I think my family, my friends, I mean, that's who really gave me the most support. And in the end, they talk about bodybuilding as an individual sport, but it's really more, it's something that requires a whole team. It's not just an individual thing. So sometimes you have to start there, but then when you go in, you have to give yourself a vision. I mean, I consider bodybuilding an artist form. So you have to say, okay, how can I perfect my physique from this, even with the obstacle of having to train around an injury?
Criticism online, on social media is okay. And also if I read all the negative comments, that's all fine. I really care about real fans, real bodybuilding fans, and I really would like to thank everyone for really huge support, especially in the last few days, few weeks. That really gives me a lot of motivation, and it gives me a lot of drive. And really, really thankful for that. As a favorite food right now, as I told before, I switched all my nutrition to, you know, healthy food. I really like teriyaki boy because it's a healthy food, especially the Jay Cutler bowl, which they created, you know, for the guys who train. And it's really, you know, a good meal, like I think 12 ounces of steak and rice, like 2 cups or so, and tastes really good.
He's 37. I think the bodybuilder is the best between 35 and 38, 39. I mean, even the guys are pushing the limits now, but this setback for him is probably actually a better thing because it's going to give him more drive. It's going to give him more focus on what he wants to become.
4 Jay Cutler bowls.
Steak. White rice or brown?
White. You know, it could be a blessing in disguise, but you know, he has to stay healthy. That's the most important thing, because health is number one. We can all chase the Mr. Olympia title. But for him, he needs to win healthy. He needs to be able to train healthy and do what he did with all that combination to be his absolute best. But I'm sure he can come back better than ever.
Who's that? Big Bad Wolf. X-ray for my C5, C6.
Ich würde sagen, gibt nicht auf, aber das wird er ganz bestimmt. Ein Bodybuilder ist immer ein Camper und muss ein Einzelkämpfer sein, sonst kannst du in dem Sport eh nicht überleben. Insofern, ich glaube, er weiß genau, was zu machen ist. Und ich habe es schon gesagt, wenn der Körper es zulässt, medizinischer Sicht und die Wiedergenesung wieder so fortschreitet, wie man sich das erhofft, dann glaube ich, dann braucht er nicht viele Tipps, sondern er weiß genau, was er zu tun hat. Und sobald der Körper wieder kann, dann sehe ich kein Problem drin. Die Frage ist eher, und da sehe ich so ein bisschen Problematik drin, weil ich ja in der Szene war, haben die Kampfrichter dann wieder die Akzeptanz für den Dennis Wolf? Wenn er vielleicht mal eine Saison jetzt komplett weg ist, geben die ihm die Chance, wieder sich zu zeigen? Oder was erwarten die von ihm nach dieser Verletzung? Das ist immer so die Frage, wo ich mir stelle. Ist er denn dann noch gefragt? Weil es kommen jedes Jahr wieder neue Top-Athleten, ja? Und ruckzuck bist du ein Top 4, Top 5 Athlet, was der Dennis Wolf ja ist beim Olympia, auf einmal nur noch ein Top 10 Athlet. Und dann musst du mit überragenden Leistungen dich wieder empfehlen für diese vorderen Platzierungen. Und diese überragende Leistung muss immer ein Stück weit mehr sein, wie das, was du vorher gebracht hast. Wo du vielleicht einfach aktiv auf der Bühne standest. Geben sie ihm die Chance nochmal, sich zu zeigen. Ich glaube, da ist die große Frage.
Dennis, you know, mentally, to stay focused on what got him to where he is. This is just a bump in the road.
Die Frage wird sein, hat er das Herz nochmal dahin zu kommen? Hat er den eisernen Willen nochmal? Dass er das Potenzial hat, steht außer Frage. Thank you.
worry about what people are saying on the outside. You just got to turn that off. You've got to get in the gym. You've got to slowly, each week, you know, shoot for certain goals. And he's going to get his size back in no time. He's in the best place in the world to do that, Las Vegas. He has some of the great support team. I mean, his wife's always there, always helping with the food and everything, giving him the positive influence. She's been there since day one.
The most scareful and fearful thought I have, you know, it's not being able to walk on the Olympia stage again, because I still have not accomplished what I think I can do. You know, I was always thinking I can win the Olympia, and now with 37, the first time, you know, I'm injured in my life.
Dennis Wolf belongs in a bigger show, so he can't go and do some little show just to do a qualification. He needs to go and show, okay, I'm back.
Ich wünsche es ihm, dass er das Herz noch hat und dass er das, den Ehrgeiz und den Willen noch in sich trägt. Dann kann er es wieder ganz nach oben schaffen, ganz bestimmt.
Yeah, of course, there's so much in your mind. But the first thing is always like, you know, am I going to be the same as before? You know, going to be playing the same league?
And he's got to pace himself. He can't do anything according to what other people tell him he needs to do. He needs to do exactly what he wants to do.
Even if life throws rocks on you, just get up again and move your ass, because you decide what's up with you. I still keep going, I'm still pushing myself, I still motivate myself to be where I want to be. I have a tattoo on my foot that says, a man who doesn't fall doesn't get up. That's the difference between losing and winning. That's what it's all about.
Dennis Wolf needs to decide what is next for Dennis Wolf, not because anyone thinks it's the right move for him.
Let me tell you, it's not the first time people walk me off. I went through this all already in 2009. I had the biggest success after the time. Stick to size. Let me tell you this, and remember my words, this isn't over. I'm not done yet.
Devil in the low, devil in the road that's leading you home. Devil in the heart, devil in the heart, devil in the love.
Last thing I want to say is thank you very much for watching this movie. Thank you for supporting me in the last few weeks and months. Thank you in believing in me. Vielen Dank fürs Zuschauen. Vielen Dank für eure Unterstützung. Vielen Dank, dass ihr weiterhin an mich glaubt. Спасибо вам всем за поддержку.